his essay, The Temporality of the Cinema of Attractions, Tom Gunning argues that the spectators of early cinema enjoyed the moving image primarily as an attraction, rather than as a form of storytelling. Early films such as Arrival of a Train at a Station by the Lumiere brothers captivated their viewers through the very phenomenon of movement itself, rather than using narrative to keep viewers engaged. Throughout the essay, Gunning sets up attraction and narrative as two separate modes of spectatorship. In classical cinema, narrative integration functions as dominant, but attractions still play a role. Moments of spectacle, performance, or visual pyrotechnics, with a subordination to narrative functions varying from film to film. In order to complicate Gunning's assumption that attraction and story are at odds with one another, this video essay looks at Man with a Movie Camera and Speed Racer, two films in which the attractive power of the cinema is at the heart of the narrative. In these films, attractions drive the story, often literally. Man with a Movie Camera is an experimental silent film directed by Dziger Vertov in 1929. Reworking documentary footage in visually striking and thought-provoking ways, the film communicates the power of the cinematic image through montage. As much a film theorist as a filmmaker, Vertov believed the camera to be a kino eye, which could give humans perception beyond what they naturally had access to. I am kino eye. I am a mechanical eye. I, a machine, show you the world as only I can see it. Now and forever, I free myself from human immobility. I am in constant motion. I draw near, then away from objects. I crawl under. I climb onto them. I move apace with the muzzle of a galloping horse. I plunge full speed into a crowd. I outstrip running soldiers. I fall on my back. I ascend with an airplane. I plunge and soar together with plunging and soaring bodies. Sounding not unlike an action film, at the heart of Kino Eye is the camera's ability to show us the world in new and exciting ways. This attractive element of cinema is continuously on display in Man with a Movie Camera, which Vertov uses to communicate his narrative. For example, this assemblage of striking train movements are edited to appear as if they wake a woman from her slumber. The train, which serves as a metaphor for the cinema throughout the film, due to its powers of movement and visual similarity to a celluloid reel, jolts the woman awake, just as Vertov argues the cinema can do for humanity's perceptions. As such, Man with a Movie Camera is continually reframing reality in intriguing ways with techniques like stop-motion animation, slow motion, freeze frames, and superimpositions. These attractions are not for cheap shocks and laughs, but actually constitute cinema's power to reorient our senses. Digital technology presents a new frontier for the cinema of attractions in the 21st century through new capabilities of image generation. Jurassic Park stands out as one of the first significant integrations of computer-generated imagery into blockbuster cinema when dinosaurs were digitally composited into the film. Just as the characters in the film are astonished by the breathtaking sight before them, studios use these new digital technologies as an attraction to audiences.
We're gonna make a fortune with this place.
Stephen Prince argues that the CGI in Jurassic Park, as with most commercial films, strives for perceptual realism. A perceptually realistic image is one that structurally corresponds to the viewer's audiovisual experience of three-dimensional space. While the dinosaurs are obviously not real, they are rendered in a way that makes them physically believable. Speed Racer, on the other hand, challenges the viewer's perception of space in a way that only digital attractions can. Based on a Japanese TV show from the 60s and directed by Lana and Lily Wachowski, Speed Racer is a story of a young automobile racer negotiating a corrupt racing system. The film uses extensive CGI to produce visual attractions which break rules of physics and photorealism in an homage to the original cartoon. In a similar fashion to Man with a Movie Camera, the attractions are not at odds with the story, but are baked into the very narrative of the film, particularly in the final sequence, where Speed's displays of kinetic mastery are so impossibly captivating that he exposes the corruption within the racing system. And just as the diegetic spectators are astonished by Speed's racing, and honestly kind of aroused, the film invites its audience to marvel at the visual delights that computer-generated imagery allows for. For example, the final moments of the race see Speed propel through a cylinder of red and white squares. The finish line has literally warped around him as he spins through it. This is just the beginning of the digital attractions on offer in Speed Racer, including extreme deep focus, the warping of space, and some very wacky superimpositions. In many ways, the film is a manifesto on the potential of digital imaging technologies to provide audiences with unreal experiences. Just as Man with a Movie Camera uses avant-garde editing techniques to transform everyday perception, Speed Racer uses digital effects to similarly challenge the spectator's faculties. In conclusion, this video essay has complicated Gunning's distinction between attraction and narration in cinema by focusing on two films which put the attractive power of cinema at the forefront of their stories. Every medium can tell a story, but only the moving image can transform our perception of reality through its powers of attraction.